Hello, my beautifuls. Welcome back to my channel. I'm so excited about today's project. We're going to be making a beautiful necklace inspired by the sea, and we're going to be wire wrapping this gorgeous Nautilus polished pendant within our frame. For those of you that are new to the channel, my name is Nilay Patel. I'm the owner, designer, and educator of Silver Silk and More. And my job is to bring you guys fun tutorials, but also do all of the background shipping, all of the order placements, the making of the knitted wire, like all the stuff that binds the scene. Basically a one-man show here. But that's what makes it fun and creative for me. And you guys certainly inspire me to do what I do best and provide the top products and high-quality products to you guys. You can find out more about my store at silversilkonline.com. You can follow me on social media at my handle at silversilkandmore over on YouTube as well as Instagram. And if you're looking for an even more wider selection and variety of inspiration and designs, you can check out our Silver Silk Silkies Facebook group. There we have a thriving community of wonderful designers, other educators, and just some really big-hearted people that are very much into Silver Silk and enjoy sharing their work and talking about what it is that inspires them, but also have questions sometimes that we like to answer behind the scenes. So this is a live show, and so I will be posting questions, or actually my friend who's behind the scenes, Miss Joan Dice. So y'all give her some snaps for helping out in the background. We'll be posting some comments and questions that kind of come up as we're doing the show together live. And so I'll be answering them, talking with you guys, and just having a good time because that's what jewelry making for me is all about. And hopefully it is for you too. So let's get into today's project. I'm going to flip around to my bead board here. Hi, Maria. Good afternoon, everyone. Pleased to be back at our next tutorial, but it's sad it's our last day. I know. But don't worry, Maria. We've got a pretty good calendar set for 2023. So we'll be back with a lot more designs and fun for sure. All right. I'm going to start off with my tools first. I've got a pair of cutters. This is Lindstrom cutters that I use for beading wire, leather cord, craft wire, any sort of soft stringing material. Or half hard wire is perfect for these cutters. So I recommend having your favorite pair of cutters to the side. I've got a pair of tapered chain nose pliers and or crimpers. We won't be using the crimping part of these pliers. I just really like the narrow tip for getting into tight spaces, opening up Silver Silk end caps, using these for jump rings. They just have a really wide variety use. And I just enjoy having them on the side there. I've also got a pair of wide nose pliers that are from my favorite company, a tool company called Weber's. And these have been dipped in a product called Tool Magic. So you'll notice that these tips are white and they also look a little rubbery. The substance essentially cures overnight. It takes 24 hours once you dip it in your pliers into the substance. And it basically rubberizes the ends with a silicone coating. Therefore, you can grasp onto small objects a lot easier. You can also crimp my findings with these, the end caps, which we'll talk about a little bit later, and not worry about anything getting marked or nicked or scratched or what have you, because we never want to do that with our findings, right, darlings? We need to keep them nice and shiny, and these pliers and the tool magic is perfect for that. So, I recommend having a pair of wide nose pliers, but also the tool magic on hand. You can grab that from softflexcompany.com. Let's talk about our materials. So we have got a few different things at our table here. So these things came in the kit. If you did grab the C kit, which many of you did in, I think, my kit sold out in less than 2 days, which is bizarre. But I only had a select number of them because you guys know that I pack exclusive, right? Then you will have all of these materials. And if you don't, you could probably use these same techniques if you've got some sort of a resin frame at home that you can, you know, wire wrap around and attach these different things together. The other component of my kits includes silver silk that's custom made. Which you can't really get in my store, but you can probably find some other chains that might accommodate the design and complement these materials accordingly. So just something to think about. All right, I've got a teardrop shape frame, as I mentioned. Typically, this is used for like resin or, kind of filling in with a material, clay even, polymer clay perhaps, or epoxy clay. In this case, we're just gonna use it as a frame to wire wrap around. And it's perfect for the pendant that I'll be using, which I mentioned is this Teardrop of Shiva little Nautilus pendant that I grabbed from a friend of mine. He's a vendor. Him and his family own a business in the Philippines and was so sweet to put together these little Nautilus shells that I kept around for, gosh, I think around half a year. And then I was like, okay, I found the kit. I found the project that I want to use these in finally, and got around to creating this amazing project and found a way to really showcase it and not do any sort of heavy wire wrapping because I'm not the perfect wire wrapper, but I know there are folks that are out there that have incredible pendants that they've made with just wire wrapping, but I am not there yet. So I wanted to pick a project and some materials that we can all kind of do and learn from as we make this design. So you'll need those two things, and you can use any sort of flat bead or button or pendant that you might have at home as well, as long as it kind of fits in the frame and that it's not sticking out too far along the surface of the frame itself. You'll need a toggle clasp. So I got a cool decorative toggle clasp here. You'll need about 4 jump rings that are 6 millimeter and the inner diameter. They've got to fit on the toggle clasp. So that's something to keep in mind whenever you pick out your jump rings. You'll need an assortment of beads. I am a very big minimalist. I like to show off and focus on the main component at hand, which is the shell pendant. And so the beads are really just here to complement and accent and add a little bit of interest, visual interest. It's not going to cover up the shell. So it's important to keep in mind to keep your beads small. So here I've just used some 4 millimeter bicones and a few of the these little Chinese glass crystals. And you can use even some seed beads if you want to, because they're small enough. So I just have about 6 total, 3 of each. I've got my single strand end caps. These are perfect for ending a chain or even leather cord, because I've used it for that before. But this has a single channel that has teeth inside of it, and the teeth grasp onto whatever you insert and crimp into this finding. So in this case, we're going to be using some leather silver silk, which I don't carry in my store. So if you, again, picked up that kit a long time ago, then you will have some custom-made silver silk and consider yourself very lucky. It may come back in another future kit because I do like to surprise everyone every now and then. So that is my end caps. And these are also custom plated. And so the silver plating that you see is tarnish resistant, and all of my other findings are also custom plated. So it's going to have a consistent color across the board. I talked a little bit about the knitted wire. So in opposite to what I've been sort of talking about this past week, which is either capture chain or even pipe chain in some of the other tutorials, in which, by the way, you can check out the entire library over on YouTube and some of the playlists in there as well, where I cover the other chains. This one is a leather that's been a 2 millimeter leather cord that's been knitted over with antique white wire. Again, this could come back in a future kit, so just be on the lookout. And I do have many other kits available on silversilkonline.com that have custom-made knitted wire. I love the fact that it is custom and exclusive at the same time. It's such a fun product. You can do so much with it, and it adds so much level of intricacy and detail and, a different material and textile to put into your design. So I really love using it. I love showing it off, in fact. And I think this project is just very, very exceptional and a great use of silver silk as well. So have some out for the side. I have what it appears to be about 18, maybe 20 inches. You may want to measure around your neck. Hi, Jennifer. Love hearing Nile over the truck audio. My granddaughter is watching. Rain loves Nile. Love you, Rain. Thank you guys so much for watching. And I love you, Jennifer. Jennifer is one of my favorite people, and her emails are just so. I can imagine her voice reading her emails with the exclamation points, the all caps. She's so excitable and such a lovely person. And I knew we would hit it off as friends from the get-go. So I love that. Jacqueline says you are a chain making genius. Thank you. I try and get my colors right. So measure it out to see what your preferred length is around your neck. The clasp is going to be in the front, and so you can really get as tight to your neck or as loose as you'd like. In this case, I'm sticking with my 20 inches, or is it 18? It is actually 18. I used the measurement on the board here. So I'm going to have that out to the side. And then I've got just a collection of a bunch of pearls. These will be used. Well, first of all, these are 4 millimeter glass pearls. Let's back up a little bit. And the other thing that I forgot to get on my table is my wire that I just noticed. So you'll need 4 millimeter glass pearls. These are going to be wire wrapped around the frame itself. Which does bring me to the wire, which I forgot. So I'm going to flash this picture up there and have you guys take one last look at it before we get into our tutorial. But the wire that I like to use as I'm grabbing it is the SoftFlex company craft wire. And this wire is perfect because it is non-tarnishing, it is silver plated. And here we go again. I'm back. So this is the stuff, and it's again 26 gauge. So I love their craft wire. It is very easy to use because it's so flexible and soft on my fingers. And I can just do a wide variety of projects. I typically like to use between 26 gauge and 20 gauge for my projects. So that's usually what I've got on hand. Hi, Kathy. She says, I feel silver silk really elevates my designs. Thank you. That is a beautiful comment from a beautiful designer. I love your seeing your projects in our Silkies group, Kathy. You're just really killing it out there with our with the designing that you do. All right, I'm gonna grab some 26 gauge wire. I've cut about 2 feet in total. And what I'm gonna do is start to wrap around the base of my frame here. And I'm going to be close to where the clasp will attach to. So I'm gonna grab my chain nose pliers and just coil this around a couple times. Okay, just a couple times, nothing too crazy. So what you can do now is grab a pearl. See if they don't jump out at me. And I'm going to start to wire wrap around the frame one pearl at a time. Okay, so the trick here is to stack the pearl right on top. And what I do is I kind of pull down toward me and then I gently push up. And I'm going to coil once and then do another pearl. So we'll do that all the way around. I'll continue to do that same technique so you guys really get the feel and groove of this. So Joan is commenting, Neely will be putting together all of the orders this week and shipping them. Yes, ma'am. Yes, that is so true. There's been a lot of chaos behind the scenes with trying to get the workshop in order and finally can combine some orders that you guys have been doing or putting in and getting those things out the door as our New Year's approaches us. Okay, this is really, really easy. The trick is just having the right wire gauge and the right size pearls to work with. But you can see that that's shaping up quite beautifully. Right. So we'll just continue to wire up our pearls. And I have a bunch of pearls out. Exact number, I'm not really sure. I've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. So I've got 16 pearls at my table here that we'll be using. And I'll also try and get this on camera to the best of my ability here. Okay. Remember, do a wrap between each purl. That's going to help secure it in place. That already looks incredible. So, show of hands, hopefully you guys are making some stuff at home. If any of you are, let us know if you're making some stuff today, or maybe you might be at work and catching a quick break. Maybe you might be watching this recording later as your schedule allows for it. But we love hearing from you. Just love chatting with you guys. I've got my coffee this morning. I'm excited about evening classes because it will be fun, and Miss Joan will be joining me live as well. I did talk her into that. We'll both have our cowboy hats on. It's gonna be a good time. Okay, there we go. All right. So far, no runaway pearls, which is good because sometimes when I do this, inevitably I will have a pearl that falls off my table, gets flung across the room, that disappears magically on my table. You just never know. Beads can be very tricky, you guys, and they sure do have a mind of their own. Also, if pets are involved, that's probably makes it worse, right? But it's also cute. You can't help it. Okay. Moving right along. The 2 feet of wire should be able to be enough to cover the entirety of the pearl wrapping here. And then we'll probably cut a fresh piece for our Nautilus shell that we're going to be caging inside of our resin frame here. Okay. Just some easy wire wrapping. This is quite relaxing and probably really satisfying too at the same time, just because it's so easy to put together. You can see how quickly this is coming along. And I am squishing my wire wrapping as I go along here to accommodate for more space. I definitely want to try and get all 16 pearls on there. This is also great because you can, again, just use the same technique and idea for wire wrapping another type of frame. Even if it's a square one, some of my other kits have featured different styles of frames that you can kind of play and craft with. And so you can use pearls, you can use seed beads, gemstones would look really cool. Okay, there we go. But I'm doing this in practically a matter of minutes. And you could see that I'm already halfway through with my pearl wrapping. There we go. Just a few more pearls left as we're doing this, and then I can go back to explaining the rest of this pendant and how to finish it. This sort of wire wrapping is truly satisfying, though, just because it's so easy to do. And again, I am not a wire wrapping expert. I know there's so many other artists and designers out there that are really, really pros at it and have practiced their craft and really honed in on that talent and made it their perfect livelihood. Wire wrapping has never really agreed with me, and I think it's because I've just got impatient fingers, maybe. And so I love doing these sort of easier projects because it's so satisfying. Okay, there we go. I guess I could have cut a little bit of extra and then I would have had enough to wire wrap around. But I think I might be able to get away with it. One, two. I might be able to get away with it. So if you did end up having extra wire that you cut, let's see if I can do this efficiently. Rather than cutting another piece, I could just use up what I've got, right? So I just coiled it. I'm going to coil it twice around the top part there. And I'm going to now sort of create a minimalist cage for my Nautilus shell. I'm going to start by stringing on a bicone crystal. And all I'm doing is just kind of going around the pearl and off to a different side of my pendant here. That's really the trick to this, is just to cover as much space without wire wrapping the heck out of it, because all I'm trying to do is just hold that Nautilus in place. Ooh, Kathy says you can make your own frames easily with a jig or using a quadrille paper to bend equally. That is a good idea. That's a really good idea, Kathy. Yep, you can absolutely do that. Okay, looks like my wire kind of wants to go off in this direction, so I'm covering quite a bit of ground here. You could see that it's starting to come together. So there's really no right or wrong side to this pendant, which is kind of cool. So whenever you throw it on, you can have it facing any direction, but you want to make sure that you distribute your beads evenly from the front and the back side. So I'm just going to string a bead there. I'm going to go through this side, come around the back, string on one crystal at a time. Patty says, love how the Soflex wire doesn't get brittle on long wraps like this. Absolutely, it really doesn't. Stays very soft through the whole process. So before I start to kind of complete this loop, I want to slide my Nautilus pendant in, and then I can kind of just kind of gauge where the wire needs to go so that this thing won't fall out as I plan on wearing it. And so I'll just go around with my wire and get a couple more places here in. Okay, did I use up? I didn't use up all my beads, so I can probably do that on this side. Hi, Gail! Jennifer, I have caught Nile singing before too. But I thought that was I was the only one that noticed that. No, I do like to sing occasionally. I'm not as good as Sam from Sam's Bead Shop, but I sure do like to have fun. You guys crack me up. I do not have an amazing voice. Maybe you're just easily impressed by my silliness. But that's so sweet. You're such a sweet lady, Gail. I'm so glad you're part of the Silkies family. So there we go. I just kind of wire wrapped around on both sides until I got it secure. Again, just keeping with the minimalist style. What I can do now with that leftover piece of wire is just go ahead and wrap it as accurately and as tightly as I can around the coils I previously made. And that's pretty much it. If you wanted to be real fancy, you could go back in and create little bends and shapes into the wire as such, just by placing your chain nose pliers right on top of the wire and then kind of giving it a slight fold. It's not necessary to do that. It's a great way to hold beads in place, though, I will say that. So I'm just going to do this in a couple spots where I think it'll look cool, just to enhance it a little bit. But otherwise, that's our pendant, you guys. That's like the main part of this design. And now it's just a matter of putting it all together. So I'm going to start with my end caps. These are open pretty wide, and the 2 mm chain is just perfect for fitting that right in. And I'm just going to give this a nice, good, tight squeeze, y'all. Just like that. Go ahead and do that to both of them. Okay, easy peasy. And now we get to connect everything together. So the clasp is connected to, I feel like I'm going to sing like the skeleton song here. The hip bones connected to? No, I'm not going to do that. But you do want to kind of connect this in such a way that it's going to dangle off of the toggle clasp. So I'm going to attach my toggle clasp, the round part first, and then I guess this will go on the other side here. The other half of my toggle clasp is connected to the chain now. And then it's just a matter of using the last two jump rings here to connect my pendant to my clasp. So I'm going to open up a jump ring just by pressing one end out toward me and one end away from me real wide, and then inserting in my round part of my toggle clasp and going ahead and closing up my jump ring. You do want to make sure that your jump ring is super closed, so be sure to check all of those seams as you're connecting all these things together. That's a really an important step that I always forget to mention, is making sure that your jump rings are fully closed. Okay, and then all you do is just add in your pendant. And boom, you can now wear your toggle clasp up front as a decorative element, whoops, and not worry about it falling off or anything. But also, it's just so much easier to put on, take off. And it looks so decorative and just a beautiful drop with our wire-wrapped pendant in that elegant silver silk. So I love this project. It's super, super easy and smart to put together. And I don't know, just gives that nice sea breeze vibe to it, I think. So I'm going to scroll back and see if anyone had any lovely comments or silly ones and or questions. Hi, Dev says, happy Aloha Friday. Absolutely. To you too, friend. My friend from Hawaii. Always keeping it bright and shiny and beachy up there too. Let's see. Oh, YouTube friend, you are doing just fine, Nile. Thank you so much. That is so sweet of you. Thanks for tuning into our little workshop this week. Let's see. Oh, Kathy says you can tack it with foam core to hold it. Oh, I bet that would be good for wire wrapping some of the design too. Foam core is always just a great thing to have on hand for all sorts of stuff. So I love that suggestion. All right. Oh, chimed in again. Oh, beautiful necklace, Nile. Thank you. You're so sweet. Kathy says, I love this design. Stephanie says, beautiful, gorgeous. Tu Tao says, beautiful design as always. Thank you. You guys are always supportive and so loving and always just very cheery and encouraging. So thank you guys so much. We have got one more workshop class coming up later at 2 o'clock today. So let me flip myself back around here. And there will be hats involved. So bring your party hat and some cocktails, of course, because it'll be the afternoon and it is 5 o'clock somewhere. And we will continue on with our last project for this workshop. Stephanie is asking, will the 26 gauge wire work for this project? Absolutely. And in fact, it'll work for the next project too that we will work on this evening. So have your 26 gauge wire out for all of the different projects that we have covered so far, except unless I said otherwise, which I think there was only a couple, but otherwise, yeah, 26 is a good way to go. But yeah, I'm looking forward to this last project as well. It's gonna have some suede cord in it and another great way to use a custom silver silk chain, just like we did now. And it'll be, oh, there we go. Sabrina is a martini up. Absolutely. So much celebrating to happen, y'all. So I will leave you guys hopefully inspired, invigorated, and ready to create. And if you haven't gotten around to making this yet, I hope that you will at some point today or this weekend. Happy 2023, or upcoming almost. 2022 was certainly memorable and delightful and had a lot of great memories made this year. But we'll get into all that later for the next show. So I will see you guys again at the next tutorial. I love you guys so much. Thank you for being beautiful silkies. And I will see you here soon. Mwah.